We have a problem here where we know the pressure of chloroform at 25 degrees C, and we know its mass density. And the question is, what's the molar mass of chloroform? So this is assuming we don't know the chemical formula and we can just look it up, but instead we're trying to measure this. And what we're assuming, of course, is that this is an ideal gas in these conditions. So pressure times volume, number of moles, gas constant, and temperature. We're given the temperature, we're given the pressure, and we're given the mass per volume. And what the ideal gas law can give us is the number of moles per volume. So we should be able to relate these two. The mass per volume, or the density, is 1.25 grams per liter. The number of moles per volume, just rearranging the ideal gas law, is the pressure over RT. Pressure, 195 millimeters of mercury. Gas constant, we've got to find one in the appropriate units. And the temperature, 25 degrees C plus 273.2. This makes the temperature in Kelvin. So what we want is a gas constant that's going to have units of millimeters of mercury and liters, since our density, mass density, is in liters, and then moles per degree Kelvin. So let's look up that gas constant. So here's the value I've looked up for the gas constant. So I'm going to put 62.37 here with the units indicated. And so millimeters of mercury and Kelvin cancel. And I'm going to end up with units of moles per liter. Now we have the number of moles per liter at 1.25 grams per liter. And I know if I essentially convert units, 0.0105 moles per liter, I'll end up with the number of grams per mole, which would be the molecular mass of chloroform. And so we end up 119.2, probably with our significant figures, the molecular mass is 119 grams per mole. That's as many significant figures as you could justify from the data given.